real shit, man. I do that sometimes in the car. I get really frustrated. Yeah. Like, I've done, like, especially coming back from that job.
Yeah.
Just scream if I help sometimes.
Right, yeah. But again, not since 2009. That shit hasn't happened. It happened, like, 3 to 7 times a day. And then, yeah, it was like, you know, I'd always have to, like, excuse myself from rooms and things like that because you could feel it kind of coming on. But, yeah, man, I also had really bad asthma. So I was like, you know, I'm glad that life is a lot easier to deal with, you know, when you're not having to fucking deal with that. So I,
well, I hope it helps out. A lot of people listen to the show that we discuss situations like this. A couple of days later, they send me emails and they're like, damn, we're happy you're talking about, you know, everybody goes through weird shit.
Oh, sure. But
yeah. This has been going on with me for about 3.5 years now. These panic attacks at jiu-jitsu. I got a panic attack, a little tiny one at the Wilton Theater. I got a little tiny one at the goddamn Comedy Jam.
Were you performing at the Wilton?
Yeah, dude. Yeah, I can see that. Like, we'll walk down on stage and I will fucking whatever. And, you know what? I breathe out of my nose. That helps. And I got the surgery. So I got
to do the You ever do the meditation thing? You ever try that out?
I sit by myself every morning. Like, my legs.
Yeah.
You know, I kept my spine straight.
Yeah.
I close my eyes and I breathe for about 7 to 10 minutes just out of my nose. Then I put a mouthpiece in. And I breathe. So this is something I work on.
Yeah.
Because it bothers the fuck out of me. When something bothers the fuck out of me, I work on it, you know?
Yeah.
I don't try to really kick it to the side. So, possible. She has a mouthpiece, and he said that if you do a certain workout through the mouthpiece, it will eliminate asthma because it makes you push.
Oh, really?
So you clip your nose, and you just breathe in and out. It just makes your
lungs.
No.
Diaphragm.
Stronger.
Yeah.
You know, so I do a little workout in the morning, so that breathing has helped me a lot. I can't find it. But you know where I get anxiety? You ready for this? The original one with the Comedy Store.
Really?
Really? The main room, I'm fucking Baryshnikov.
Yeah.
I come out jumping and slinging on the fucking little room. Every time I walk up to the steps, I get to the top of the steps. And I take my jacket off. And throw it on the chair, and if I have enough time, I sit. Then the light comes on, and the comic before me, and my heart starts racing. This is bringing me up. I just keep breathing. I make sure I got water, breathing. As I'm walking up, I'm basically dying. Once I hit the stage, it just dumps. And then I do what I do, but those 6 minutes are a fucking nightmare.
Yeah.
And man. And it happens with the stars, without the stars, with marijuana, without marijuana. Yeah. Like, I've experimented. Like, well, you know, I get anxiety, absolutely, because I'm eating 18,000 milligrams of THC. There's somebody chasing you. When you get 1,800 milligrams of THC, you know what I'm saying? No, this night's I won't eat for 3 or 4 days and went down there. Sure enough, the original Friday at 11:30. I woke up, my heart's beating out of my chest. I feel like I'm gonna fucking faint.
Yeah.
You know, I'm looking minus 2 miles an hour and I'm gasping for air.
Yeah.
When you guys say anxiety attack, what do you mean? Because I don't know if I've had an anxiety attack. I'm probably
sure don't have anxiety attacks.
Like, sometimes things slow down a little bit. Like, it'll seem like a little bit.
Definitely doesn't slow down, or it didn't slow down for me. I get like
sped up, but slowed down at the same time.
Yeah, again, like, I just had sort of symptoms of anxiety attacks. I don't think, you know, it was this sort of panic. You know, because I don't want to compare it to that, because I don't know what other people feel like. They feel that panic. I just know that for me, a lot of things that he's talking about, the heart and the chest, but it was a racing mind, so it was like, it wasn't slowed down, it was just like, you get all this information, and it can be information that you got 5 days ago that's just suddenly just pelting your head all at once, and you don't have a place to put it, almost, and, you know, it feels like you're going to pass out, but there's no passing out, so that was, you know, that was one of the things, too, but, you know, like, I would just sort of, like, break down in tears a lot, too, you know, just be sad, like, you know, something horrible happened. But then what's weird about it, I don't know if you remember this, but like in like real stressful situations, I can handle shit. Like, do you remember that that car crash that happened right in front of Lampoon that time, where that chick, her eyeball like exploded and stuff? like, hey, you can't do that. And I'm like, dude, you either help or don't, you know, kind of thing.
Jesus.
And then I went around the corner after all of that happened, and they get her all bandaged up, get her in, take her out, and I, like, puked and start crying and, oh, my God, stuff like that. So then that's when the attack happened. But during it, that was, you know, it was fine. That's when everything slowed down and everything was, like, calm. But yeah, the panic attacks were just, it's just this, you can't, I would always kind of describe it as that, you've got, like, six wheels turning, and they're all kind of turning at different speed. They're all different sides. Sizes, and I've got to slow them down and get them in sync somehow, and I can't do it, you know, and that's, you know, that was sort of the beginning of it, and that's what you're always trying to do, you know, that's what I was always trying to do.
I don't think I get full-blown anxiety attacks. I get panic attacks when I'm on the bottom in jiu-jitsu, and I can't breathe. That's when I start to panic. I start to breathe through it, like over the years, I've learned how to something. Sometimes I just tap and I have to get up and just breathe. But then I get right back on the bottom and start all over again. I'm not gonna lie to you, you know, you drink a soda and you get an edible. Mm. And you get on a plane and you mix caffeine with that edible. You know, I've been to the point sometimes in that place where I've said to myself, I can see me freaking out.
Yeah.
And they just get up and start yelling for the elements, you know? Like, that's the point, but it's edible portion. It's not my own mental.
Yeah.
Like, I never, when I get that state, you know, I don't hear a fucking beep out of me, you know what I'm saying? It's
yeah.
Like, well, yeah, I'm going to drum, no. I'm just going to pass it out. I'm a pass out artist.
Yeah.
You know, when I see blood, I pass out needles.
I remember that, yeah.
Yeah, I'm one of those fucking books.
Do you ever pass out in front of him?
No. I just remember him telling me that, and I was so shocked by that.
I did that one night. I went to.
It was a UFC.